Welcome to the Card Showcase, where we take a closer look at the cards making waves in Teppen and talk about how to use and defeat them. Today's card is Chill Penguin, a red unit that debuted in the Devil's Awaken expansion in November of 2019. Mega Man fans will know the history behind this card. Chill Penguin made his debut as a boss in the first Mega Man X game in 1993. He was a Maverick Hunter that got bored of being stuck in the South Pole. That's when he decided to ally with Sigma and the other Mavericks during his uprising. He's appeared in a few other titles like Mega Man Extreme 1 and 2. Chill Penguin is part of the small group of cards to have multiple versions, the normal art, which you see here, and the animated secret art. Onto the stats, he is an epic rarity 3-4 with growth 3, meaning it needs 3 growth points to level up. At levels 2 and 3, it gains a shield, and at level 4, it deals 6 damage to a random enemy unit. It costs 4 MP to play. It's pretty obvious that Chill Penguin fits in with mono red decks because he deals direct, uncounterable damage from his 4th growth level. The shields in his early levels make it much more likely that he will survive to deal that damage and come out on top of trades along the way. But Chill Penguin can't do it alone. If you stick a Chill Penguin out on the board without another unit to provide a near instant shield, he's at risk for being destroyed by direct damage or action cards. So, make sure you use the buddy system and get him to level 2 right after you play him. You can also protect Chill Penguin by getting rid of enemy units in his lane with direct damage. There are a lot of options for this. Trust Amid Suspicion and Dragon Lord's Judgment are some of the most popular direct damage action cards right now. They will keep your Penguin alive for him to deal his damage later on. Speaking of action cards, let's take a look at decks where Chill Penguin does best. No doubt you've seen him used to great effect in Shinku Hadouken Ryu. Other growth units like Rashid and Thunderslime are great buddies for our Penguin, not only leveling him up, but having the potential to grow themselves. You'll also see some of the direct damage actions we mentioned a moment ago. Grizzled Veteran and Liberating Slash are also solid choices. Ryu is the best hero choice for Chill Penguin. Unfortunately, he doesn't fit very well with Common Jill or Rathalos decks. Chill Penguin is definitely a good unit, but he is not unbeatable. Let's take a look at how each element can deal with what Chill Penguin does. Red needs to destroy the enemy Chill Penguin before he starts gaining levels. If your opponent is smart, they will always use the buddy system to get a near guaranteed shield when played. Throwing a unit to trade damage with Chill Penguin is important. You can rely on direct damage units like BB Hood and Lagiacrus to do the job, but sometimes just playing 3 units and filling your board is the best option. Then one of them falls and you didn't spend a ridiculous amount of resources to try to just pop one enemy unit. Green has a very straightforward counter in Seal, which eliminates all of Chill Penguin's growth potential. Disarm is an action card that will seal an enemy unit, and ZZ Yaku is a unit that will seal the unit in front of him. Use both of these options to shut down Chill Penguin's potential. Purple has quite a few options for handling the Penguin. One of the best counters for him is Hell Antenora, the 4-cost 2-5 that deals damage every time it is damaged. If you're playing 4-cost Purple, Beltway can bounce Penguin back to the EX pocket and reset his growth. If you've managed to deal even a little bit of damage to the Penguin, you could also snatch him with 4-Eyes. Demonic Intimidation is also another option to bounce it back to your opponent's EX pocket. But at the end of the day, you could just Shadow Blade Chill Penguin as soon as it hits the board. The black element is just about as straightforward as green. The element has tons of cards that destroy units, which ignore shields if you weren't aware. Sample Collection, Obliterate, Corrosion, Just Desserts, and many others will do the job. That's it for this Teppen Top Card Showcase. I hope it was helpful and informative to you, and if it was, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss the next one. Also, what cards do you want to see me cover in this series in the future? Be sure to let me know in the comments. I read and respond to every single one. See you next time.